Well, the George W. Bush rehabilitation tour is still making progress through the United States. And yesterday at the National Constitution Center in Philadelphia, George W. Bush was awarded the Liberty Medal. And that medal was actually placed around his neck by none other than Joe Biden himself. Now, Biden's not the one who made the decision, but they thought it would be nice to have him at the ceremony to honor that great, great American president, George W. Bush. Now, we have seen in recent months that George W. Bush's approval ratings are actually going up. And a lot of that is because, yeah, when you compare him to the abrasiveness of Donald Trump, he seems better on the surface. But everyone seems to be forgetting that this man, George W. Bush, is by definition a war criminal, as was his entire administration, and yet none of them were ever held accountable for it. George W. Bush authorized torture of detainees. They rounded up people, even ones they knew were not involved in any kind of terrorist activities ever. They just cast such a wide net, scooped up as many people as possible, threw them in CIA black sites or at Abu Ghraib or down in Gitmo so they could torture them, so they could demean them and hold them for years without any kind of due process whatsoever. And this is the man that the National Constitution Center decided to give the Liberty Medal to. George W. Bush was about as unconstitutional as they come. And when you look at his records of human rights abuses, starting wars based on lies, lack of accountability, the corruption, the deception within his administration, it's difficult once you start looking at it to say that he is worse than Donald Trump. Because I don't think that he is. I think people have forgotten about all of the horrible things that this man and his administration did because on the surface, again, Trump's out there tweeting horrible things. And George W. Bush wasn't a tweeter. Hell, it didn't even exist for most of his presidency. But Trump is, and he's abrasive, and he's mean, and he's rude. George W. Bush was just this bumbling idiot that some of us actually kind of felt sorry for a little bit. That shouldn't be how it is. The man knew exactly what he was doing. Yes, he had this public persona as a buffoon because he was about as dumb as a brick, but he surrounded himself with some of the most evil people to ever serve in Washington, D.C., and he went along with every single thing that they said he should do. He does not get a free pass. He does not deserve any kind of Liberty Medal or any other kind of award. The only thing that this man deserved, which Obama could have given to him, was a prison sentence. But unfortunately, that time has expired. And George W. Bush gets to get away scot-free and continue on with his image rehab tour that is doing a really good job somehow of convincing Americans that he wasn't such a horrible president.